Good morning, children. Today we'll continue with the topic food adulteration. Yesterday I had asked you to go through the topics of reasons why adulteration is being done. We'll continue with reasons. In your books, you can open page number 113. There you will see the reasons. Merchants and traders to make quick profit. The merchants and traders, they do this adulteration because they want to have a quick profit. And shortage and increasing prices. In the market, they show the shortages about the different items of food and then they increase the prices. So this way they are adulterating the food as well as they are having the profit also. Consumer demands. Many a times consumer demands something. And when it is not available in the market, the demand increases day by day. And what happens when the consumer demands is increasing day by day? They start increasing the profit just by doing the adulteration part. They start doing the adulteration by adulterating the food items. You know what is how adulteration is being done? Like taking out the inferior mixing of inferior particles to the food and taking out valuable things. Okay, so they do this for the profit sake. Then lack of awareness. Lack of awareness, many a times we don't want to know what is going on. We should be careful what is going on in the market. Suppose during Diwali time, you all must have seen that there's lack of and shortage of khoa. You know what is khoa? Made of milk. This is because of the scarcity. You will not find that khoa in the market, and after some time you will see ki it is available in the market, and then the food material which is available in the market, it is fully adulterated because of the demand of the consumer. So many a times we should be aware also what's going on in the market, and we should do according to that. Influence, indifference and lethargy among consumers. We should not be lazy about these things also, because these things are very important. It is related to our health and we cannot take it granted as far as our health is concerned. And enforcement of food laws. And we should also follow the law. Wherever we see that there's some problem is going on in the market or from where you buy the things, you have to be careful. And many a times you can go to the forum also. You can inquire why these things are happening. You might be getting the might not be getting the proper answers, but at least for you, when you will inform, people will get to know that what's going on in the market. So food adulteration is dangerous as it affects the health. You know that it is dangerous at times because our health is affected, and we cannot take it for granted because our health is concerned. And it may be toxic and deprive one from essential nutrients. And in this way, if you are not very careful what we are eating, what we are using, what will happen? We will take in toxic and material which is not very nutritious. And suppose you are paying for the nutrition part and you're not getting it. Foods may be adulterated either intentionally or incidentally at all stage from production to selling. And what happens with this adulteration? What happens? Many a times the traders and people who are doing this adulteration, they will do it intentionally, knowingly. They add inferior particles to the food items, and at the same time incidentally वी एड ऑल स्टेजेस फ्रॉम प्रोडक्शन टू सेलिंग. इन ऑल द स्टेजेस यू विल सी दैट थिंग्स आर बीइंग एडेड विच इज नॉट हेल्दी फॉर अ बॉडी. ओके देन वी विल सी व्हाट इज इंटेंशनल अडल्ट्रेशन. Added deliberately to increase the margin or the profit. When you are adding something which is inferior in quality deliberately, jaan bujh ke you are adding, then it is intentional adulteration. The quality of food is deliberately lowered in order to deprive maximum profit from sale. So the quality is being lowered by adding inferior quality, and the traders are getting maximum profit out of it. It caters to the consumer's tendency to be guided mostly by price. And usually what happens, consumers, they go mostly by price, visual appearance. They don't see how the product is, but they will see, if they will see the price is low, they will see and they will think that the food item is good. If item is looking very good or appealing to eyes, they'll think the food item is good. And claims made by advertisement. And many times what happens, they are also, consumers are very much also encouraged by the advertisement. If they'll see an advertisement of any food item in the TV, they'll think it's very nice and they go for it. This type of adulteration includes the intentional addition or subtraction. Intentionally, we are adding something or subtracting, or abstraction of substances which adversely affects the nature, and we are taking out something which is valuable, affects the nature, substances and quality of food. And what happens? We are decreasing the quality of food by taking out the valuable materials. For example, sand, marble chips, earth and other filth may be added to grains, spices. You see, in grains, dal, chawal, and whatever grains we are available, you know, people add sand, marble chips, earth and other filth. These things are added to spices, pulses, etc. These, besides harboring disease, bearing bacteria may affect the lining of the mouth. You can imagine if these, after this intentional adulteration, what happens? It may also affect the lining of the mouth. The lining of the mouth is affected. Intestinal tract may also harm the teeth and gums. You can imagine intestinal tract. Intestines are also affected because of this adulteration. And our teeth and gum is also affected. Talc and chalk powder may be added to wheat flour and grounded spices. You can imagine talc and food chalk powder is added. These being cheap add to the bulk of the food. Because why we use chalk and talc powder? Because they are very cheap, and they are cheap, and when they are added to any food item, it will add to their bulk. Wo unke bulk ko badha dete hain, unki quantity ko increase kar dete hain, thereby increasing the margin or profit. In this way unka jo profit hai, margin hai profit ka, that increases. Addition of starch to sweetmeats adds to bulk एन अपियरेंस ऑफ फूड. जब हम स्टार्च को स्वीटमीट्स जो बेकरी प्रोडक्ट्स हैं उसमें हम ऐड कर देते हैं तो क्या कहते हैं, उसकी क्वान्टिटी इंक्रीज हो जाती है, एंड एट द सेम टाइम अपियरेंस ऑफ फूड इज ऑल्सो लुक्स गुड. दो हार्मलेस स्टार्च, इफ यू आर एडिंग स्टार्च इट इज़ हार्मलेस, बट वैन यूज इन प्योर फॉर्म कैन कॉज स्टमक डिसऑर्डर्स. लेकिन जब हम प्योर फॉर्म में स्टार्च का यूज़ करते हैं तो वॉट हैपन्स, स्टमक डिसऑर्डर्स हो जाते हैं व्हेन कलर्ड विद टॉक्सिक पिगमेंट्स लाइक लेड, क्रोमेट एसेट्रा. और इस तरीके से दे बिकम टॉक्सिक इन अ वे, एंड आर इंटेस्टिनल ट्रैक एंड सम स्टमक प्रॉब्लम्स अराइजेस. देन वाटर एंड एक्सेस मॉइस्चर टू फूड सच एज मिल्क, पनीर, कर्ड एसेट्रा. वी कैन एड, यू नो, मिल्क, इन मिल्क वाटर इज बीइंग एडेड, एंड पनीर, कर्ड्स एक्सेट्रा. आई येस्टरडे ऑल्सो टोल्ड यू इन पनीर ऑल्सो टैल्क पाउडर, चॉक पाउडर इज ऑल्सो एडेड. इन कर्ड्स ऑल्सो दे एड स्टार्च, चॉक पाउडर, एंड ऑल्सो आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट ब्लॉटिंग पेपर ऑल्सो. डिप्राइव द कंज्यूमर ऑफ हिज मनी वर्थ. दो वी आर पेइंग फुल मनी, बट वी आर नॉट गेटिंग फुल प्रोडक्ट 100% product. If the water added is not clean, they may lead to gastrointestinal disturbance. Knowingly that we are paying the full amount, we are not getting the full amount also. But what happens, suppose in milk they are adding water, we are not very sure the water which they are using whether it is clean or not. So we have to be very careful when we are buying milk from outside. We have to be careful that we boil it very nicely, so that whatever infectious things are being added to it, it may get ruined by boiling. Addition of saccharin and other chemicals at sweeteners instead of sugar or honey to sweetmeats increases and bakery goods. You know that in bakery products and all the sweets and all which is made, people add saccharin, which is not good and healthy, instead of sugar or honey. Sugar or honey is better because it is sweet and it is good for health, but saccharin is just not good for health. Excessive use of flavorings, colorings, preservatives, emulsifying and stabilizing agents, etc., may prove harmful to the consumer. Many a times we use lot of flavorings,